Brothers and sisters, please rise as we come together in prayer. Friends in Christ, let us now delight to hear once again the message of the angels, and by faith to travel unto Bethlehem to see what God has wrought through the manger child. Let us, through the Holy Scriptures, behold the unfolding of the hand of God and the manifestation of his matchless love for the world. Let us rejoice for the privilege of being recipients and guardians of God's grace and truth. May we extend this marvelous gift to all who stand in need of God's mercy and help, to the poor and helpless, to the oppressed, to the sick and those who mourn, to the lonely and the unloved, and also for ourselves, that we might know the peace that passes all understanding, and let our light shine throughout the darkness of this troubled world. May these prayers and petitions be acceptable in God's sight, as together we offer the prayer that Christ himself taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Be seated, friends.
Thank you. of Jesse. A shoot shall come out from the stump of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of his roots. The Spirit of the Lord shall rest on him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord. His delight shall be in the fear of the Lord. He shall not judge what his eyes see, or decide what his ears hear. But with righteousness he shall judge the poor, and decide with equity for the meek of the earth. He shall strike the earth with the rod of his mouth, and with the breath of his lips he shall kill the wicked. Righteousness shall be the belt around his waist, and faithfulness the belt around his loins. The wolf shall live with the lamb, the leopard shall lie down with the kid, the calf and the lion and the fatling together, and a little child shall lead them. The cow and the bear shall graze, their young shall lie down together, and the lion shall eat straw like the ox. The nursing child shall play over the hole of the asp, and the weaned child shall put its hand on the adder's den. They will not hurt or destroy on all my holy mountain, for the earth will be full of the knowledge of the Lord, as the waters cover the sea. Thanks be to God.
The Annunciation. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words, and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God. And now, your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son. And this is the sixth month for her, who was said to be barren. For nothing will be impossible with God. Then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. Thanks be to God.
The birth of Jesus. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken place while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was a descendant from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in the manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. Thanks be to God.
Thank you. shepherds abiding in the fields. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to the God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." Thanks be to God.
The shepherds hurried to Bethlehem. When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told them. Thanks be to God.
What does the Lord require? Hear what the Lord says. Rise, plead your case before the mountains, and let the hills hear your voice. Hear, you mountains, the controversy of the Lord, and you enduring foundations of the earth. For the Lord has a controversy with his people, and he will contend with Israel. O my people, what have I done to you? In what have I wearied you? Answer me. For I brought you up from the land of Egypt, and redeemed you from the house of slavery. And I sent before you Moses, Aaron, and Miriam. O my people, remember now what King Balak of Moab devised, what Balaam, son of Beor, answered him, and what happened from Shittim to Gilgal, that you may know the saving acts of the Lord. With what shall I come before the Lord and bow myself before God on high? Shall I come before him with burnt offerings, with calves a year old? Will the Lord be pleased with thousands of rams, with 10,000s of rivers of oil? Shall I give my firstborn for my transgression, the fruit of my body for the sin of my soul? He has told you, O mortal, what is good. And what does the Lord require of you but to do justice, and to love kindness, and to walk humbly with your God? Thanks be to God.
Thank you. Herod and the Magi. In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem, asking, "Where is the child who has been born King of the Jews? For we have observed his star at its rising and have come to pay him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was frightened, and all Jerusalem with him. And calling together all the chief priests and scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. They told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for so it has been written by the prophet, 'And you, O Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah. For from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel.'" Then Herod secretly called for the wise men and learned from them the exact time when the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, "Go and search diligently for the child, and when you have found him, bring me word, so that I may also go and pay him homage." When they had heard the king, they set out. And there ahead of them went the star that they had seen at its rising, until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage. Then, opening their treasure chests, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they left for their own country by another road. Thanks be to God.
Thank you. flight into Egypt. Now after they had left, an angel of the Lord appeared to Joseph in a dream and said, "Get up, take the child and his mother and flee to Egypt and remain there until I tell you. For Herod is about to search for the child to destroy him." Then Joseph got up, took the child and his mother by night, and went to Egypt, and remained there until the death of Herod. This was to fulfill what had been spoken by the Lord through the prophet, "Out of Egypt I have called my son." Thanks be to God.
Thank you. the Word. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him. Yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood or the will of the flesh or the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us. And we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Be seated, friends. Let us pray. O living Christ, we need your love today to shine in the dark corners of our world, where loneliness and hatred, war and suffering, greed and lust destroy. Come to us and shine in our lives that we may more perfectly love you and reflect your love on earth. Amen.
It is wonderful to welcome those here in the sanctuary and those here online to this beloved Festival of Nine Lessons and Carols. I hope that being immersed in the scriptures and music of this season deepens your experience of the holy birth that we celebrate at Christmas. We are delighted to welcome Frank Zeligny, South Church's Director of Music and the Artistic Director of the Music Series, to lead this festival. We are deeply grateful to him and to Sarah Asmar, Managing Director of the Music Series, for their countless hours of preparation to make possible this wonderful service. We are happy to welcome back Carrie Miller as our guest organist and several guest singers as well. South Church holds as part of its mission making music to glorify God and move the human spirit. We pray that this festival has achieved that. Also, key to our mission is serving our neighbors here in the heart of the city. Both of these missions are supported by our offering tonight. Half of the offering received will be used to cover the expenses of this festival. The other half goes into the South Church Survival Fund. This fund assists individuals in the church and the community with basic emergency needs. It also pays for the Christmas dinner we serve to the community, which South Church has provided continuously since 1971. This is indeed our 50th consecutive year. On Christmas Day, some 400 meals will be served by takeout and delivery. If you are interested in volunteering, there's a sign-up board in the small parlor just through the door up front to your left. Due to our mask requirement during the pandemic, we are not holding a reception this year. However, the music series is holding a holiday market in the Assyrian Memorial Parlor. You may get there by exiting through the door to your left here in the front, then following signs that lead you in one-way traffic to the large parlor, where several tables are set up with lovely holiday goods. After shopping, you will exit through the small parlor. We hope that you will consider supporting tonight's offering generously. For those here in person, as you leave the sanctuary, there are offering plates on either ends of the inside aisles in the nave, and one in the balcony near the piano, and one here near the door. Those who are participating online may make a secure donation at the musicseries.org site. We thank you in advance for your offering and pray that in sharing with others, you also may be blessed.
The Birth by Anne Weems. It was an ordinary event. After all, women give birth every day. The baby cries, the woman puts the child to breast, and the world goes on. God did not pitch a tent among us in an extraordinary way. Jesus arrived as all of us do, powerless and dependent, a baby. What ordinary means for the Son of God? No royal robes, no crown, nor was there priestly garb. In fact, there was no garb at all. Just a naked baby, born to dwell among us. And yet, in that ordinary place, holy was the night, for holy were the hearts of those who heard the word of God in the ordinary birth cry of a child.
The Word became flesh and dwelt among us. So let Christ's light shine in the darkest corners of your life. Let Christ's light and love shine in the darkest corners of our world. God is with us. We are not alone. Thanks be to God. Amen.